I thought it was slightly conservative, coming from Paris, and by that time I was very much interested in Schoenberg. I found his music well made, a little mild, a little cute, but well done. Not cute. Let's take this word back. Pleasant, a little bit on the pleasant side. There was no bite to it, so to say. But it took me a while to understand that the thought world from which Papineau-Couture emerged, French Canada, a part of French Canada, which he very much identified with. I mean, he, as you know, his family settled in on the island of Montreal in the 1640s. And the name Papineau is one of the great names in French Canadian history. So in a way, what he gave expression to is this recherche, bucolic, gentility, peacefulness, and playfulness, which is, I learned years later to identify as one of the strands of Quebecois culture.
While Papineau-Couture's cultural background may have made him especially receptive to the neoclassical aesthetic, the Montreal composer and pianist Bruce Mather feels that Papineau-Couture continued to broaden his style over time.
He changed a great deal over the years. If you take pieces like Psalm 150, which is like 54, 55, something like that, which is very much a Stravinsky aesthetic, but magnificent. Piece I revisited all of this quite recently, and I found the string quartets, the two string quartets, to be really absolutely outstanding. But a work from I think 73 or 74, Slano for string trio, which is I think a marvelous piece, but light years away from his early works. No, he was constantly developing, and of course he didn't accept in the new techniques. He didn't accept everything, but he's an example of a composer whose language did evolve a great deal.